Namaskar. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to the 9th edition of Tiger Pataudi Memorial Lecture, presented by Air India, a Star Alliance member. A joint initiative by the Bengal Club and the Telegraph in association with the Oberoi Grand Calcutta. May I request Mr. Sumit Joshi, General Manager, the Oberoi Grand Calcutta, to come up on stage and deliver the welcome note. Mr. Joshi.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you for being with us today. The Oberoi Grand, with its legacy of over two centuries, becomes the ideal place for this event, as it encompasses yet another story, another tale, another insight, another inspiration, another reason for us to be together. From the oldest members who've been part of this since the inception of the Pataudi lecture, to all the new guests who've come here for the first time today, we extend a warm welcome. Without much ado, I would want to hand over to Arubda to continue this evening. Thank you so much.
Let's have some more. Another lovely square cut. The net's gone through before.
I think we met at a cricket party in Calcutta. He had come to play, and of course we were all cricket mad and cricketer mad also. It was the man that I loved, and it seemed to worry everybody else that he was a nawab. Like, it would be height of ayashi, and you know, he was feudal and he didn't have a 9-to-5 job.
Senior Nawab, whatever little I saw, he was a man who could create innings like Gavaskar. While Nawab was exactly opposite, he will go for the ball. No comparison between two styles. He was the most intelligent captain I have seen in my life.
Tiger was the first captain, to my mind, who told us in no uncertain terms, look fellas, we're not playing for Bombay or Madras or Punjab or Delhi or any other state. We're playing for India. Think India. My only complaint is that he was too lazy, he was too laid back. Can't imagine a captain of a side not having a kit bag of his own. See, he would use somebody else's pads, somebody else's gloves. The bat is the most important element. And then he will say, all right, like that, all right, this is all right for me. And he'll just pick it up and go in.
The earliest memories I have, I think, of being really tiny, people saying, hello, beta, what does your father do? And I'd say, he's the captain of India, and be very proud.
I did play some cricket at university. I played one match and he told me after that, he said, I forbid you from playing cricket ever again.
So I think I would have loved to have been there, you know, during the 70s, basically, with both my parents. Because it was a different time. And you see the stories, you see the pictures, you see the kind of life they had. The glamour combined with the simple nuances. But that era was something else.
How glad the many millions of Timothys and Williams with me to capture me.
From being a prince in Bhopal and Pataudi to Oxford and Winchester and India that it was in those days. And of course, playing international cricket with one eye. He was like Al Pacino to me. Slightly taller version. And definitely better at cricket.
And that's gone through for four, and that's his 100. Pataudi, 6 test 100.
He had no one eye. He had no one shoulder. He had no one thigh. Because he was threw out of the windscreen of the car. With all those such handicaps, he was still the best fielder of the era. Lovely knock was at Melbourne. Don Bradman himself came in lunchtime and he said, young man, I wish I had some shots like you. What a tribute.
When you get older, it's the mad things that you've done is what you remember, no?
On another occasion, he took some cricketers deep into the woods. Suddenly there was a group of dacoits raiding the cricketer. Unhone ek ko pakda, Vijay Manjrekar. Latka diya usko, ki ye get us this kind of ransom, otherwise he's going. And Manjrekar didn't know, honestly, till the time he died, he didn't know that this was all stage managed.
And I remember him coming and telling me, I've written this for you. Dile nada, tujhe hua kya hai? Aakhir is dard ki dawa kya hai? Next day, I said, Firoz, you know, Tiger's done such a wonderful thing for me. Firoz said, you idiot woman. That's Ghalib, for God's sake.
A loss for Indian cricket today. Former Indian cricket captain Mansoor Ali Khan Pataudi is no
more.
The man oozed style on the field where he was a terrific cricketer. Off the field, the classic gentleman.
I think the most important thing Abba has demonstrated by example, what it is to be honorable and correct and dignified and strong and silent.
Thank you, Shumidda. May I now invite Mr. Devdan Mitra, editor sports, The Telegraph, to introduce the speaker for today's evening. Please.
Respected Sharmila Tagore ma'am, Mr. Azharuddin, distinguished sportspersons, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to yet another edition of the Tiger Pataudi Memorial Lecture. We would particularly like to thank Sharmila Tagore ma'am, as her gracious presence gives these events a special aura. It was at Calcutta's Eden Gardens 35 winters ago that Mohammed Azharuddin, aged 21 then, first stepped on to a test match wicket. We are ever so grateful to you, Azhar Bhai, for agreeing to return to the city for today's lecture. Thank you. Imran Khan, now the Prime Minister of Pakistan, was the speaker at the inaugural edition of the event in 2012. Since then, we have had Greg Chappell, Saurav Ganguly, Kapil Dev, Mike Braley, Bishan Singh Bedi, Courtney Walsh, and David Garr as our honored guests, all former captains and distinguished cricketers. However, what sets Azhar apart is the fact that he's part of the legacy that Tiger Pataudi left behind as a cricketer from Hyderabad. Mohammed Azharuddin was born on February 8, 1963, just about 11 months after Mansur Ali Khan, the Nawab of Pataudi, took over as India's cricket captain on March 23, 1962 in the Barbados Test against the West Indies at the age of 21 years and 77 days. Despite their differences in backgrounds, both Tiger and Azhar had plenty in common. Like the elegant masters from Hyderabad, such as Abbas Ali Beg, M.L. Jaisimha, and later V.V.S. Lakshman, both Pataudi and Azhar were instinctive batsmen. On one day, the flick through mid-wicket would be played from way outside the off stump, and on another day, depending on the mood of the batsman, the same ball would be carted through the covers with equal disdain. And when not donning the pads, both Tiger and Azhar understood the importance of fielding much before IPL changed the way players dive around. I am fanatical in my demands for keen fielding. This, to me, comes first, with everything else a poor second, Pataudi wrote in his 1969 memoirs, Tiger's Tale. One of the first things he is said to have told his team after taking over as captain of Sussex was, "Gentlemen, let's see some scuffed trousers and bruised knees and elbows." Pataudi would have been pleased with Azhar, scuffed trousers, bruised knees and all. Like Tiger, Azhar covered the ball with agility that was a sight to behold. Azhar whipping the ball back with a flick of the wrist over his own back often is an image etched in memory. Even in this, artistry outshone athleticism. And of course, both captained India with distinction, and if one may add, used spin to great success. There is yet another bond. Pataudi would become Calcutta's beloved Jamai on December 27, 1968. Azhar's love affair with Calcutta began on the last day of 1984, when he made his test debut with a century. In all, Azhar would score 5 test hundreds at Eden Gardens from 7 tests, a record only matched by fellow Hyderabadi Lakshman, at an average of over 107. Azhar does have a fondness for the name Eden. His 192 at Auckland's Eden Park remains one of the finest test hundreds by an Indian test batsman overseas. In fact, that Azhar had a special bond with Calcutta's Eden was revealed by him in a 1993 interview to Sports World, the magazine published by the ABP Group and edited by Tiger Pataudi. India had just whitewashed Graham Gooch's England 3-0 at home, with Azhar stroking a classic 182 in the first test at the Eden Gardens, an innings that resurrected his career. Asked about his feelings when he walked in to bat for the game, Azhar told Sports World, "Of course, I was a little tense, but I was confident of getting runs because it was Calcutta. I had this feeling that something was going to happen." Ladies and gentlemen, we now present a short AV to reflect on Azhar and his artistry.
A crowd of 80,000, the biggest of the tour, packed Calcutta's Eden Gardens to see an Indian team.
Single Malik will have to hurry. Oh, and has he caught him? Yes, he's caught him. is not happy at all. This game suddenly changing.
Leads 41. Well played.
I thought people loved me more in Bengal. When with the advent of Ganguly, I became number two.
Ladies and gentlemen, it's my pleasure to invite Mohammed Azharuddin.
Respected Sharmila ma'am, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen. At the very outset, when you showed the AV, it reminded me that I've become very old. That's the honest truth I'm telling you. But I'm very happy to be back in Calcutta, and I must admit that Calcutta, as far as my cricket career is concerned, has been a savior, especially the Eden Gardens. And the amount of love and affection I got from the people of Calcutta, I mean, I don't think I got anything from any other cricketing ground in India. I think people really egged me on to do well. You know, there were times, you know, we've not played well, especially the 96 semi-finals, I still remember. And we had a very tough time even going back to our respective homes after that loss. I remember very well. And I think that's how the game goes. You know, game is always a great leveler. Sometimes you're there, sometimes you're not there. I mean, if you see the Indian team also, you know, they played really well in the T20s, but I mean, at times, you know, I mean, it evens and levels you out all the time, you know, because you can't be on the top all the time. But I'm very happy to be asked to give this Mansoor Ali Khan Pataudi lecture. And sir, I mean, I have what can I say about him, you know, because outstanding personality, too much grace, and too much style. That's the only two words I can tell about him. I think when I was young, I think he became captain even before I was born. So I've had not many meetings with him, but whenever I met, you know, it was very warm. And the first time I think I met was when I just scored my 300, and then we won the 1985 Benson Hedges World Championship, and then we were going to Sharjah, and he was sitting next to me. And I was so scared, you know, I don't know what I should talk to him, you know, because I've heard a lot about him, heard a lot of stories about him, but he made me very, very comfortable. He says, just relax, don't worry. I mean, it's a very short flight, say 2.5 hours. I'm not going to say anything to you. So, I mean, I was very tense, you know, because when you're sitting next to a man, you know, of so much grace and poise, and I mean, the way he played for the country, and the way he was respected, just not in India, all over the world. I mean, some of the players, the older players who I just tease them, you know, just try to get the best out of them. So whenever I say, sir, please tell me about Pataudi, sir, what you have to say? They swear by him. I mean, I promise you that. And they always say that, you know, without him, we would have struggled. We would not have been in this place. I mean, we would not have achieved so much. I mean, he really gave us the freedom to do well and to relax and play. And I think the first captain who showed us to win games abroad, which he did it with a lot of grace. Actually, I was supposed to read this because I'm not very good at reading and talking, because whenever I did this political rallies, and people used to come in and give me this paper, you know, that's why you have to read this and all those things. But I get very numb when I have to read something. You know, so I always tell them, I'll speak whatever comes from my heart. Today is going to be the same thing. I'm going to speak from the heart, you know, and Maybe I might read some of the things, you know, which is very, very nicely said about Pataudi sir. I mean, sir was indeed the tiger of cricket, scion of the royal family of Nawab of Bhopal. He brought a finesse and class to a game which has since remained unmatched. Till today, he remains the youngest test captain in Indian cricket history. In 46 test matches he played for India between 61 and 75, he scored an impressive 2,793 runs with an average of 34.91, I mean, which included six centuries. I think this 2,793 runs, I mean, in today's time, I mean the way they used to play on wickets, you know, sometimes uncovered wickets, sometimes difficult wickets, it would be nearly close to 6,000 runs. And maybe the six centuries will be more than 15. I mean, as far as I can think, I mean, the way they played at during his time, you know, when he deserved, I mean, much more than what his figures tell, you know, because at that time, not many matches were also played. Like now you see, I mean, if you open the TV, any channel, you know, every day you can see a cricket match. You know, not only India playing, but any other, between two other countries. And I think his eyesight was taken away, one eye, I mean, he lost it in those that accident, you know, because, I mean, I was speaking to Ian Chappell also, I mean, some time back, you know, very long back, then he was talking about Tiger Pataudi. He told me that with one eye, he was such an outstanding player. Imagine as if he had both the eyes, you know, I mean, he would have been somewhere else. So that's a great compliment from Ian Chappell. You know, Ian Chappell speaks from his heart, and he doesn't listen to nobody. Whatever comes to him, he says, you know, that's why he's been a very good captain as well, like Pataudi sir. And my meeting with sir was, I think that I met him many times, you know, whenever I used to go to Sharjah, and we sometimes had free time, so sometimes he used to come down very rarely. I mean, he used to come out of his room, you know, very rarely. If you really want to see, I mean, like a tiger, you know, if you go to the jungle, you know, it's very hard to see, you know, sometimes it's a very shy animal. So sir was also, I mean, I felt he was a little bit shy, but it's very rare to find him, very rare for us to, you know, even meet him or see him, you know, because he was very reserved, and then till you go and talk to him, he'll say hello, yes, that's it. Beyond that, I mean, that was his style, that was his Nawab, you know, he was Nawab. And like now, just now, I mean, Bishan Singh Bedi, Bishan Paji was saying that, you know, he didn't have anything, any cricket gear with him. Oh, he didn't need to have, he's a Nawab, you know, he can take anybody's. So really, it was not in his genes to carry kit bags and all those things. You know, he would just go there, he had that talent, he possessed the talent, he's been bestowed upon the talent by the Almighty Allah, and he really, I mean, made sure that, you know, I mean, he played to the best of his ability, and he gave a lot of enjoyment and entertainment to the people of India and all over the world. So, with the one eye, I mean, he was such a great player, and fielding, outstanding fielder, you know, like so many people have told about his fielding. I was very unlucky that I could not see him play. I was very young, you know, but I distinctly remember, I mean, he got in one match against the West Indies in 1975, I think two matches, I think he was injured if my memory serves right, but in one match, I think he got 250 or something, 170 and 180. So I distinctly remember that, but then the last test match also, I think it was played in Calcutta, if I can remember correctly. If I'm not correct, you know, please excuse me. But I think that was the last test match in 1975 he played. But I think I was very happy to be playing for Hyderabad, you know, where the Nawab of Pataudi also played. I think the DDCA, when he came back from England, he started playing for the Delhi District Cricket Association, the Delhi cricket team. I mean, I don't want to take names and all, but I think he had problems playing for Delhi, you know, because he could not match with those people, you know, because coming from England, you know, had a different attitude. He wanted to win all the time. He wanted to inculcate good habits in the people, the winning habits into the side, but I think he failed to do that in that particular period of time. And then Mr. M.L. Jaisimha, I mean, was one of our stalwarts, you know, who played for India. And I must confess and admit today that I have learnt a lot from him, more than his son. In fact, I'll just go slightly away from this and then I'll come back again. And I think the 182 you're talking about, and a lot of people, like, since morning I've been listening about this 182 I scored, 182 I scored. I know I've scored 182, but how I scored, I mean, nobody knows, actually. So I want to tell you something, because 2 days before the game, Mr. ML Jaisimha was also here, you know. Then he was very close to me, you know. He used to really like me as a boy, you know, like, since I was young, you know. He really, I mean, made us play with him, you know. He used to play, actually. I think he was 44 or 45, till then he used to play, you know, but still he was very good. And he came, we were talking to him, and then he actually showed me how to bat on that day. I mean, actually, he was one of the person who saved my career as well. On that particular day, 2 days before, he told me in that match, and then I went on to score 100, and then from here, we were going to Kolkata. Sir was also, Mr. Jaisimha sir was also sitting, so, I mean, you know, he really enjoyed his drink all the time, you know, everybody knows, ma'am, you know more than anybody else. So he was like, when we won the test match, he was like almost drinking till 12:30 or 1 o'clock or something like that. So then when in the morning I was like, when we were in the flight, he was sitting next to me, and suddenly he was asking for a glass of water. So I said, sir, you want water? I can give you, I have water here. No, I don't want this, I want tonic water. So I said, sir, I told him, sir, you have, I'm like, you've been drinking till 12:30, 1 o'clock. Now it's just, take it easy. He just looked at me and said, you mind your own business. So that's how Mr. Jaisimha sir was there. And then when he became very good friends with the Pataudi sir, I think during the, when he came back from England, I mean, he had so problems, as I've said, you know, mentioned the DDCA, you know, still the same, you know, so many problems still going on. Again, everybody knows that. But anyways, he asked him to come and play for Hyderabad, which he readily agreed. And then from 1966 to 76, he played for Hyderabad. And how lucky we were to, I mean, have him play for Hyderabad. Then I promise you that there's so many people in Hyderabad, people who have old, I mean, who have seen Pataudi sir play, say, you know, whenever we used to know that Pataudi sir is going into bat, the whole Fateh Maidan was to get full. And then the moment he got out, everybody used to leave. Because he had such an impact on Hyderabad cricket, you know, I mean, it was always very, very helpful, very jovial, and they say he was a very big prankster. I mean, as Bishan Paji is also saying, it's some story about Vijay Manjrekar, but I was very happy. And then he was bestowed upon with Padma Shri, and then Arjuna Award, and all the other things, you know, that he really got going, you know, I mean, really, he deserved everything. And when I was growing up, I think when I was in 10th standard, and Saad Bin Jang and Amir Bin Jang, I mean, used to play with me, you know. The Saad was Pataudi sir's sister's son, his nephew. And I remember, you know, there's like in the olden times, you know, when they used to have the good flannels, you know, and good shirts, you know, then these people used to wear all these and come, Amir bhai, and Saad. So I always used to look at them and say, Saad, what is this? Itna kahan se aa raha hai? Nahi, mera mamu ke kapde hai, ye bolte. So then used to play with Greenickel's bat at that time, you know, that time. We used to play with a parchment white bat, you know, where we used to, I mean, I'm sure so many people, Sambaran Baranji sir also must have played with that, you know, here. So we used to play with that, and they used to come with this Greenickel's bat and all these things. And then used to tell the stories about the Mamu and all, so we used to cleanly listen. But at one point of time, we had a camp in every May, we used to have a camp in Hyderabad. So we used to have a coach from outside. And one time in 1977, we had Mr. Lala Manath as our coach. But I think the total, I mean, Saad was there and Amir Bhai was also there in that camp. The total attention of Mr. Lala Manath was only for two players in that camp. So we cannot complain, you know, because Tiger Pataudi's nephew means a very big thing. Nobody used to go near them, but they only say, Nawab Saab, Chote Nawab, batting karo, Bade Nawab, batting karo. So it was like that. Tamir Bhai was Bade Nawab and he was Chote Nawab. So they used to get full attention. But I think we learned a lot from the camp, because Amir Bhai was very, very close to me. Saad also played with me. Then Saad, when we were playing a match against, in the schools, I think he was called to play for Southern or President game where he got 100 against the West Indies. To me, I think it's very unlucky that he could not play for the country. I mean, I was given to understand, you know, I was very young at that time. I think he scored that 100 in 1978 against the 78-79 against the West Indies. I mean, where Marshall was just coming into the side. And that they gave the excuse that he was not a very good fielder. I mean, I can promise you that there are so many players who played for India who were not very good fielders. So that's a very lame excuse. I was very disappointed. As an outstanding player, he had so much talent. He was much better than us, way, way, way beyond us. But very unlucky that he could not play for the country. That was one of the, I mean, reasons, you know, he just left it. You know, he was very lazy. He was like the same thing. He never carried his bag also. Sometimes he used to come into the bus in the morning with a toothbrush in his mouth. Saad, kya kar rahe hai? Nahin, brush kar raha hun, bhai, kya kar rahe hai? बोले बस जा रही मैच खेलने जा रहे ब्रश कर रहे अरे लेट उठ गया भाई क्या कर सो ही जस्ट लॉस्ट इंटरेस्ट एंड देन ही कुड नॉट प्ले बट आमिर भाई आई प्लेड अ लॉट विद हिम बिकॉज आई प्लेड जूनियर स्टेट ऑल्सो विद हिम एंड आई वॉन्ट टू टेल यू समथिंग हियर आमिर भाई आमिर बिन जंग दे वॉज एंड एट दैट टाइम ही यूज टू बोल दैट दूसरा विद अ क्लीन एक्शन अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट आई एम सेइंग सो I mean, I used to get amazed, you know, like how I used to ask him, Amir bhai, how you used to bowl this dusra? Because it was never dusra. I used to ask him, Amir bhai, how you used to bowl this ball outside? So, dekh rahe na, main kaise dal raha hu? Dekh rahe, phir bhi puch rahe kya bolte? He was like that. So, he was very close to me. Like, whenever he comes to India, then he calls me and he meets me all the time, you know. So, we had very, very good memories. But I think the amount of impact Pataudi sir had on Indian cricket, I think no other cricketer in India has that, you know. I mean, it's like too much grace, you know. I mean, if you were standing next to him or standing far away from him also, I mean, your eyes is always on him. Like, even if you were talking to people, but still you would be looking at him. I mean, he had that aura, you know, about himself. And he carried it very nicely and a very dignified person. And I think I realized that I could meet him for the last time when ma'am was also there. We were coming from Udaipur after attending the marriage, you know, in the same flight, and sir was also there. You know, we got talking, and then he was very happy to meet me. Then as soon as after he got down from the flight, when we came out, and I asked him, sir, why don't you aap phir se kyun politics mein kyun nahi aate bolte to mere ko मैम आप थोड़ा दूर थे तो इधर थे अनस जी थे यहाँ पे तो ही सेड क्या पागल हो गए क्या मैं तुम मेरे को फिर दलदल में क्यों डाल रहे बोल के बोल सो बट दैट वाज माय लास्ट मीटिंग विद हिम बट आई लर्न अ लॉट फ्रॉम हिम बिकॉज आई हैड टू थ्री टाइम्स वेरी गुड टॉक्स एंड व्हेन आई टॉक टू हिम अबाउट बैटिंग ही ओनली थिंग ही टोल्ड मी अजहर यू आर अ बैट्समैन योर जॉब इज टू स्कोर रन्स डू नॉट एवर कंप्लेन ऑन वॉट विकेट यू आर प्लेइंग ऑन वॉट कंडीशन यू आर प्लेइंग यू आर अ बैट्समैन यू हैव टू स्कोर रन दैट्स द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग एंड देन ही सेड इफ अ बॉलर हैज टू टेक विकेट बिकॉज इज अ बॉलर बिकॉज यू आर पिक्ड एज अ बैट्समैन टू प्ले इन द टीम योर जॉब इज टू स्कोर रन एंड डू नॉट कंप्लेन एंड वन थिंग ही क्लियरली टोल्ड मी वॉज एन इफ एवरी टाइम प्ले पॉजिटिवली प्ले डोंट ही सेड डोंट प्ले टू द गैलरी बट प्ले पॉजिटिवली बट एट टाइम्स आई डिड प्ले फॉर द गैलरी एंड देन मे बी One or two times I got out, but then most of the time, I think things were in my favor, so everything went well. So it's not a bad theory at that time. But sir was a person who, I mean, you could learn a lot from him. Just not cricket, but about so many different things, you know. I mean, but whenever he used to talk, very rarely used to talk, whenever he used to talk, you know, he used to talk sense. He never used to talk anytime, anything loosely, you know. He's always, I think he's brought up in England and his Nawabi style, you know, like he never spoke loosely and he knew exactly how to carry himself being a Nawab. So, I think, ma'am, I was very disappointed that I could not attend his funeral, you know. I did speak to Saif bhai and then told him that, you know, since my son is just, I think my sir passed away 5 days after my younger son and my sister's son passed away in an accident. So that's the only reason I could not come. But I think sir is very close to the whole family, especially with Amir and Saad, a great personality. I mean, I can go on and on and on, but I think I will have to say, talk about something different also. But I think, sir, I mean, I have no doubt that he was the best person I've ever met in my life as a cricketer, with so much grace and poise. And I will be talking about so many different things, you know, as I've not written anything, you know, because they gave me so many things and written. So I get really very nervous when I have to read and talk. So whatever I will talk, I will talk on straight away from my heart. I think there are two, three things I really want to talk about is that, you know, I mean, on that captaincy issue, you know, because a lot of people say, talk about captaincy and all. But I think sir was the one, you know, Pataudi sir was the one who taught us how to lead the side, and then the legacy has been followed. And I mean, so many captains have come and gone. But I think sir's legacy, he was the first captain we'll remember always. I mean, the very youngest captain who really inculcated the habit of winning, not only in India, but abroad. And also made sure that fielding was of prime importance. During his period of time, you know, if you see the, I mean, with due respect to all the players, when they were playing with him, I think he was the best fielder, you know, I mean, like nobody could come near him, you know, like a lot of people talk about players, you know, but I have never seen him field, but I've heard from people, but he was an outstanding fielder. That's when fielding started from there, and then they had, when he stopped playing, it was a big slump. Then suddenly, after some time, it picked up. And I think captaincy is one thing, you know, I mean, I realize being a captain, you know, I think you have to, first of all, you have to win the trust of the players, and then you have to understand every player, because every player is different, every mood of a player, it varies from individual to individual. Like, I remember when I was captain, you know, when I just became captain, or maybe after 6 or 7 years of being the captain, a lot of people used to put pressure on me, like from outside, you know, I don't want to, I mean, give names, you know, because it's not nice. But why Kapil Paji and other players are not bowling or batting in the net? Because they always wanted Kapil Paji to bowl in the nets, which I was very happy if he bowled in the nets. But being a player, you know, being a player of such repute, I mean, as a captain, I don't need to go and tell him, I mean, Paji, you do this or do that. But I used to always told him that, Paji, whatever you want to do, you do. If you want to come for practice, you can come. You want to bat first, you bat. But he had a lot of interest bowling off-spin, Kapil Paji. Not many people know. Because in the practice sessions, you know, he used to bowl only off-spin. So that made the people other very angry also. Hey, why is he not bowling, I mean, fast bowling? Why is he bowling spin all? But I said, that it's Kapil Paji, he can do anything. But if you give him the ball in the hand, on a match day, he knows what to do, you know. I mean, sometimes some big players, you, as a captain, you don't need to tell anything to them. You know, you have to let them be, you know, you should not instigate them. That's when the problem starts. Because I being a captain, I never instigated any player. I never wanted to instigate any good player or saying that, can you do this or do that. And you can't be behind them, you know. They know exactly what to they are doing, they are playing, they are professional. So there are some players who, I mean, needed guidance when we guided them. I guided them, but I exactly knew about all my 15 players, what they were doing the whole time. When I was there, and nobody could go away from me. And I used to tell them, "Haan, raat mein kab aaye bhai, kidhar hai, kahan gaye the?" They used to tell me, "Nahi, Azhu bhai, room mein hi the hum log." Bola, "Nahi, nahi, yahan, yahan pe gaye the." But there, at times, you know, see, what happens is, you know, every player, I mean, approaches the game in a different way. There are some players who are very, very nervous. Then if you put them in a curfew time, 10 o'clock, then they will get out in the night only. They won't be able to play in the morning. So I used to tell my players, my boys, you know, like, see, I am letting you do anything. From the moment you enter the ground till the end of the day, that is my time. I will not spare you. But after that, you can do whatever you want, but make sure that you perform. Because that's how players, you know, become close to you. That's how you win their hearts. And that's why they will give you the best. But then if you start instigating good players, you start behaving like a leader, you know, like, okay, fine, I am the only person, nobody else is there, so I am the captain, so I'll do this, I'll do that. It doesn't work like that. A leader is not that type of person. A leader is one person who takes everybody along, even a small person, you know, like if you put a hand on, like Like if you go to the office, you know, that clerical job, you know, if you're a boss, if you put a hand on his shoulder and then talk to him for 1 minute, you don't lose anything. That's when you win hard. That's when the people want to work for you. That's how, I mean, I played the game. That's how I was a captain. I will give you one or two instances where, I mean, we were in one match. At that time, there was a Challenger Trophy. Dada was there. I mean, I remember he was also there at the ground. And we were playing India A versus India B. Yeah. B match. And I think in one game, I mean, Srinath was bowling. I can't remember who the batsman who came into bat. And then there's one fielder on covers. He came running to me. I was standing at slips. And I said, Azubhai, just keep one short leg, you know, the new batsman has come. So it was a one-day game. So I didn't think that, we'll see. I told him, okay, I'll see whether I can do it. But then as he was going away from me, it just struck my mind. I mean, he just come here and told me, I don't think it's a bad idea. I mean, what will happen? Only 6 runs. At the most, we can hit a 6. You lose 6 runs. But something inside told me that, okay, let's have a fielder. On the side, then I stopped Srinath from bowling, and then I put a fielder at short leg. And the next ball he played bat and pad and got out. So what happened in that thing? I mean, everybody said, oh, Azubhai, what a brilliant move. What did you do? I mean, that's outstanding. Every player, not many players knew that what happened between him and me. But every player was very happy. Azubhai, kya decision liya apne, bahut acha kya. So, but I got the accolades for it. But actually, he's the person who made me do that. As a captain, I get the accolade, but in the heart of what, I know that because of him, I put the fielder. If he had not told me, I wouldn't have kept the fielder here, and I wouldn't have got the wicket. So that's how captaincy is. So because captaincy is like, you must go and make sure that in one game, our national chairman, M.S.K. Prasad was, he made his debut in Chandigarh, and I just went to him, and I was standing at covers, and suddenly I went to him and told him, M.S.K., please, tell me, I'm running out of ideas, and can you please tell me what, I mean, we should do? He said, oh, no, sir, you're captain, how can I say? So then he went like that. So I told him, no, it's not the question of captain. I'm telling you, just give me some advice what I can do. But then he gave me some advice, you know, then I made him comfortable. Said, please tell me, there's nothing wrong. If I come and ask you, you know, I mean, there's nothing wrong. As a captain, I'm asking you, there's nothing wrong. So then he gave some advice, you know, it was good. That's how, captaincy is all about. Because captaincy, if you want to be a great leader, if you want to be a good captain, I mean, you should not impose upon players. You should not impose upon people. Because if you want to get the best out of them, you have to sometimes behave like them. Because you have to give them that security that, okay, fine, even if I don't play well and the captain is always there, he will look after me. That's how when big players, you can produce big players. Because I mean, under my captaincy, there's a lot of players who have played, you know, really gone on to play big cricket. It's not because of me. It's because they had that talent. I made them win matches for me, which was very, very important. I mean, like, especially Kumble and all, they really, I mean, worked very hard. You know, after that, he improved a lot after some time. So this is how, what captaincy is all about. And I feel that, you know, I mean, like, a lot of people come and ask me, Azubhai, talk about leadership. You know, leadership is very, very simple. I mean, if you want to be a good leader, you should never have an ego. The moment you have an ego, you can never become a good leader. Maybe people will respect you for what you are, but at the end of the day, when they go out of the room, you know how things happen, you know, like, okay, because they're working, you know, you can't say much, but then, I mean, that should not happen when you go out. That's how it works like that. Lot of people ask about relationship, about my relationship with the Eden Gardens. You know, it's not new. It has started from 1977 when I was 14 years old, because at that time we were playing, I think, South Zone versus East Zone. I got a 51. So my first game was, I got a 51. From then on, whenever I've come to Eden Garden, I have felt something different, you know. I mean, like, I feel that whenever I come here, you know, whenever I went to the ground, I feel that some type of a divine intervention, you know, at times. You know, if you see some of my innings, best innings have been played at the Eden Garden, you know, in that ground. I know in one match I didn't raise my bat, you know, that's a long story. I don't want to say here what happened because it's not nice. But anyways, I mean, I really was very happy and to play at Eden Garden all the time. Made my debut here. I think if other day somebody showed me a clip, that it's a 2-minute clip where, I mean, I think you showed here also, I think, in that we, I think I got 310 in some 340 balls or something like that. I'm sure people must have got very bored at that time because it took 4 days to score 100. To be, I think one day, first day I was not out, second day it rained, and third day was a rest day, and then after on the fourth day of the match I got 100. So for me also it was very painstaking. Then when I realized, look at it, and then I realized 334 balls, you know, I can't play 334 balls now. So that was, I mean, Eden Garden has always been a very special place for me. And I think in England, I think we, in 1996, we produced very good, two good outstanding players who went on to play with distinction. They went on to play for India for a long time. One was Saurav Ganguly, and the other one was Rahul Dravid. When Saurav, when Dada, I mean, I won't call him Saurav, I'll call, always call him Dada. So when Dada started doing well, my popularity in Eden Garden reduced. Because they always say, Dada, Dada, Dada. But I'm very happy. I mean, like, I was happy that, you know, like, I mean, naturally it will, you know, because he's from Bengal and he's played so much. Outstanding captain. He showed us the ways to win games outside of India. And Rahul has been a wall, as everybody says that. So we got two outstanding players in that tour, you know, very. Because I had a very, not a very good tour, and there's some one controversy which everybody knows. I think if you are a cricket fan, you will know what happened in that tour. But anyways, I'm so happy that so many people are here. And I think Hyderabad, I want to talk about Hyderabad cricket also, because I think I want to make it something interesting, because Hyderabad cricket is a hilarious team. I mean, the day passes just like that. I mean, even if you're fielding or batting or anything, I mean, even if you're losing also, the team is very hilarious. So, very, very jovial people all the time. Maskara bana, uski khich diya, uski tang khich diya. So, one match, I will say this in Hindi, I'm sure everybody will understand Hindi. So, we were playing, hum log Bombay se match tha. Main khelra nahi tha, kyunki main इंग्लैंड में जाना था, मैं काउंटी क्रिकेट के लिए तो मैं चला गया. तो बॉम्बे वर्सेस हैदराबाद वाज प्लेइंग, सो द मैच वाज हैपनिंग. द बॉम्बे वेर ऑल बैटिंग, दे वेर 731 फॉर 3 और समथिंग लाइक दैट. सो आई मीन आई डोंट माइंड टेकिंग द नेम ऑफ द प्लेयर बिकॉज इज माय वेरी गुड फ्रेंड राजेश यादव वॉज फील्डिंग एट डीप स्क्वायर लेग, एंड देन अर्शद भाई वॉज बॉलिंग एट. सो तो 2-3 टाइम्स ही स्वेप्ट, यू नो, देन ही ट्राई टू stop the ball, and then the ball just went like for boundaries. And then at tea time, Arshad was very hot, and he was bowling, almost bowled 60 overs I think in that game, and then the fielding was like loose. So my Arshad bhai bola ke Rajesh kya kar rahe ho yaar tum, har ball ball aa raha tha chhod de rahe. So Rajesh Yadav was very hilarious. One time one day I'll bring him here and he will say, I mean, he's very very hilarious. And he told Arshad bhai, it was captain Arshad bhai, ab dekhe score kitna hai. To Arshad bole, haan 700 ke upar ho gaya score. To 4-8 run gaye, to mera aapka kya ja raha hai. So that's how the Hyderabad team was, you know, because they're hilarious. I'm like, aap kabhi bhi aap khamosh nahi reh sakte, kyunki do teen players aise the, अलग ही टाइप के प्लेयर थे. दे वेरी डिफरेंट. लाइक देर वन प्लेयर हु आई मीन ही इज फ्रॉम माई स्कूल ऑल्सो, ही वॉज माई सीनियर. ही प्लेड रणजी ट्रॉफी एंड दलित ट्रॉफी. वेरी अनलक्की नॉट टू हैव प्लेड फॉर इंडिया. अब्दुल अजीम एस बी आई मैन हीज टू प्ले. एंड वन टीम वॉज ऑल आउट, एंड देन दे हैड टू गो इन, एंड play 6 overs, end of the day's play, you know. So then him and Sridhar was going into bat. So Sridhar was saying, Azim bhai, abhi 6 overs hai, aram se, we'll play out the day. Bolta, pagal ho kya? Bole, nahi, kyun kya ho gaya? Bolta, bolta, 50 runs ka khareeb karna chahiye, 6 over mein. Azim bhai, we are only at the end of the day's play, tomorrow we can come and play fresh. Bolta, achha, achha, theek hai, dekhenge, dekhenge. So at the end of the day, after 6 overs, the score was 46. Azim was batting 38. So that's how the people are there, because you won't tell them. And there was one more player, like how during that time when Pataudi sir played, people used to flock to the ground, you know, him. But there was one player who was my senior, who again, if he had scored a 50 in one game against the touring side, I mean, he would have definitely played for India. At that time, his name was Shahid Akbar. I mean, like when we were youngsters, we used to go and watch his game when he used to play for the Hyderabad Ranji Trophy team. But unfortunately, he's, passed away, but he was an outstanding player. He was the nephew of Abid Ali, sir. So, these are how, cricketers were, you know, I mean, very, very jovial team, Hyderabad. I mean, now it has become very serious because things have changed, you know, like people, I mean, like everything's become mechanical. Like, you know, you have to get time pe ye karna chahiye, ye time pe ye karna chahiye, this is what that is. The game has become very professional, which I think is very good. And other thing I was wanting to talk about the under 19 players when I saw the World Cup, you know, very unfortunate that we could not win the World Cup. But I think what came out in the finals was very, very poor. I mean, the effort from both the sides was very poor. And then I sometimes don't understand, you know, when you score 100, you know, people, I don't know why you have to use those expletives. I really don't understand. I mean, when you score 100, you know, or if you take 5 wickets or a wicket, you should feel happy, you know. I don't know why there is so much anger. I really fail to understand, you know. I mean, like, if I score 100, I will definitely, I mean, raise my bat, I'll feel very happy. But I don't know why that anger is there. You know, if you see, like, they pump the fist on, okay, fine, you do that. But then there is no need to use the language because you can easily lip read nowadays because the camera focuses you sometimes, you know. I mean, so it is, I think I will really, I mean, tell the board, you know, I think the board has to take a very strong view on this and strong action, because I think it's not good for the game, you know, because under 19 players, you know, what happened. And I think the action, if they don't take action, nothing can happen, because I think sometimes we say, okay, fine, we'll give, you know. I mean, I do understand, you know, like, I mean, all the fines are, you know, like, you have these match fees and all, you cut the match fees and all, but I think players are earning so much money, for them, 20,000, 1 lakh, it really hardly matter. But I think if you really want to, I mean, have good discipline, I think there has to be ban on the games. Like if you see in football, I mean, there is straight away ban on the game. Like I remember in one World Cup game, there was a player from Italy, I mean, he was red carded in the semi-final, and the team went into the final. He's one of the, I can't remember his name, he was one of the outstanding players for Italy. But in the final, he was sitting on the bench and watching the game. He could not play the game. So that will really hit the players, you know, because what happened on that day was, it was not at all good, you know, it was very, very bad. It was in very poor taste. And I think we only blame our players also, but I think we need to talk about the Bangladeshi team also. I think they are the people who really, players who started. You know, when they won the game, there is no need to go and, you should feel happy and then you be with the team and enjoy the moment. There is no need for them to go and, abuse or whatever happened on that time. You know, it was very, very difficult time, you know, because the board has to really, take care of this, you know, because I'm definitely, when I have a word with Dada, I will tell him, you know, because he's the president of the BCCI, and it was very nice, you know. I mean, he always listens to him, and he's as a cricketer, he would definitely understand what we are talking about. But I think there are another 2-3 things I really want to talk about is academies, you know, academies all over India, because I think a lot of people, like even today also, there are 4 or 5 people came and asked me, Azhar Sahab, aapki academy hai kya? But look, I am not in favor of academies where, everywhere you have they feel very proud. You know, a lot of people come there, Azharbhai, we have an academy, you know, have 300 people, I mean 300 boys. But I ask them, how many boys have you produced? Zero. I think, why? How can you have 300 people and then produce players? You cannot do that. Because what, I mean, when you have an academy, you must do justice to the boys who come. You know, they have so, they come with so much hope. But I know there are boys, you know, who come, their parents are very into it, you know, they want to send their boys to play. But when they don't have, when they don't possess the skill, then there is no point having them in the academy. Because then you carry on, you give them false hope. Saying, oh, aaj khelega ladka, kal khelega, next year khelega. But when he doesn't have the skill, he cannot play. I mean, a lot of people say, you know, first you have to have the skill. Everything comes later, dedication, application, hard work, it comes later. When you don't have the skill, where is the dedication? Even if you are dedicated, even if you do hard work, when you don't have the skill, then it's total waste of time. So I always, just my humble request to people, you know, whoever is, I mean, I'm not trying to, I mean, tell them to close the academy. But then, when you know the child is not good, you know, please tell their parents that he's not good. You know, he doesn't have the skill, he doesn't have the habit in him to become a cricketer. But still, if they want to send him for fitness or just for the sake of saying, then at least you have in your heart saying, okay, fine, he's coming only for making fit. But then, I mean, it's not very, it's not a right thing to do, because you're spoiling the career of a boy, you know, because maybe he might be good somewhere else, you know, he might be good in studies, he might be good in sports. You know, because I remember when I was young, you know, I used to really like football. I used to play more football. I used to do athletics also. But then I realized that, you know, I mean, I was very good at running. I used to do 100 meters running. I realized that, you know, I'm only running in football, but I have no skill. I mean, what was the view? Then I thought, you know, when I have no skill, why am I running like this? Then I used to do athletics also. Not many people know that I used to run 100 meters. My fastest time was 11.5 seconds. Yeah. Not many people know, because I did a lot of running in school, you know, because got cramps in my whole life while playing a game of cricket. I played so many years. But I think worked very hard on fitness. But at the end of the day, you know, as I've said, you know, I mean, with the academies, because if you have an academy, a state cricket academy, at least you have 30 or 40 good boys, you know, where you concentrate and produce them. Academy, when you have an academy, you need to produce boys. It should not be a money-making academy. I know it's very, money is very important. You make money. Money-making is very important. Everybody wants to make money. But at the end of the day, you know, if you don't produce players, what is the use? Because you cannot let the boys down. You know? Because I honestly, this is my personal and humble request to all the people who run academies all over the world. I really want you to run the academies, but if you run it in a good way, if you produce players, then it is good for you. I mean, a good player is always there. You know, there is no need to produce a good player. If you have a good team, like when once we had a very good team, I mean, the coach's job is very limited. And he says, man management, they talk about. What is man? I don't know what is man management. If you are a good player, well, I mean, naturally he will play well. Why you don't need to manage him? What can you manage him? Because he knows what he wants to do, what his job is. But I think man management is only players who are just coming up, you know. I mean, then you can talk to them, you can tell them. But then players who are already there, you have man management, and then like now, we have so many players, you know, then extra 11 players, 11 people or 13 people go with the team. You know, I think sometimes I feel like it's totally not necessary. But at the end of the day, what is the result we are getting? You know, when you have so many players, like in Hyderabad, when I became the president, I was watching, and they want everybody. They want 10 or 12 people are going with the Ranji Trophy team. One person has to throw, one person, okay, I understand you are a physio, trainer and masseur is very, very important. Because of the tight schedule and the thing. But I think throwing and then assistant manager and this manager, I mean, they have fielding coach, bowling coach, batting coach. And then what is the, then they have a coach. See? Then what is the use of the coach? And I mean, a coach means he has to know everything. Like, if you are a coach, then you have to know everything. Then what is the need? Okay, fine, everybody, I mean, like batting coach and all. But then the results have to come, you know. Because you spend so much money, at the end of the day, the results are not forthcoming. And especially, I'm not talking about the Indian team, but I'm talking about the teams in the local teams. And one more thing I would want is to, bring back this Dalip Trophy zonal games. Because players are suffering from it. They have this India blue, India red and India white. I mean, I think it's, I feel it is very useless, because once you have the zone back, you know, when most of the players, I mean, there are only one player who played from Hyderabad for the Dalit Trophy, and there are other players who have scored almost 600, 700 runs in a season, but they have not played Dalit Trophy because they don't get a chance because India blue, red, blue. But I think you have the zonal system, because in those times, all the players came from the zonal level. Because if you have the zonal level, there is more competition. India blue, red, you know, it hardly any competition is there. If I've seen quite a few games, but nothing really happens in that. But when you get the zonal system, there's always there at a south zone. I mean, you have to win against north zone. North zone says, oh, we have to win against east zone. I'm sure people who have, Dada played during those time, it was very good, you know, it was very good. But I think the things have changed, you know, and I think I still would want Dalip Trophy to be brought back, you know, and it's good. And I think about a lot of people talk about this test cricket going down and then clouds are not coming, but I think, the results are not, in every game you play for the last 18 or 19 years, you know, the results are always there, you know, because test cricket, you cannot fiddle. If you fiddle with test cricket, then you are fiddling with the game at all. Once test cricket dies, and there will not be any game, because all the people who are purists will never come and watch the game. Because as it is now, you know, if you talk to the people from a different era, and they don't regard T20 as cricket, you know, because if you talk to Michael Holding, he gets very furious. Man, don't talk to me about T20. So that's how it is, you know, because test cricket is test cricket, because the test of time, test of patience, test of endurance, test of skill, test of everything, you know, like standing there, you know, sometimes for a fielder also is a test of time, you know, because the only reason I try to become a fielder, I mean all-round fielder, is because, I mean, sometimes when I was, like when I made my debut, I was running from deep point to deep point. Sometimes the ball used to come, sometimes the ball never used to come. But then I used to get bored. 2 hours fielding is not easy. You have to concentrate. So then I started, taking slip catches and started standing silly point, and then I improved upon. I used to take almost like 100, 150, sometimes 200 catches. Then after that, some of the players who used to give catches, you know, they used to like, "Adhar, ek catch to chodo," they used to say. Well, no, then we used to have a bet, Pepsi or whatever. So then after that, I used to hold ice in my hand. So it was very tough, you know, because now, fielding has become very easy because the grounds are very good, ma'am, nowadays. Before, even when sir was playing, the grounds were not very good, you know, like the ball used to bump and come. Like there are so many times, you know, when I remember in one match, I was fielding at point in Bombay, then David Boone cut, and then I was in style, I was just standing, covered the body and all, and then from here, straight on my head. So at that time, it was like that only. Only two grounds were very good at that time, the Barabati Stadium and the Eden Garden. The two grounds had very good facilities, beautiful ground level and green grass. Apart from that, all the grounds were very, very hard. But now all the grounds have to be good, and that's why fielding standards have also become very good, and the players have become more fitter. And if you see, you will not see any players with a stomach or something like that. You know, before this time, at least from 15, 8, 9 players used to have that. So it was, for me, it was very tough to tell them, you know, because I know there are so many times I used to, tell them, you know, if you want to play longer, if you want to play good cricket, you know, you got to remain fit. So what, sometimes I used to tell them about food and all. So whenever I was not there, you know, they used to go and eat inside the dressing room and somewhere in the corner, and they used to eat. Arey, Azubhai ke samay mat khana, kuch bhi bol dete. But I only used to say, because I wanted them to play longer, because I knew the talent was there. But there are so many good players, you know, who have a lot of talent. Like, I can name the Sadanand Vishwanath, Shivram Krishnan, Mahinder Singh, Chetan Sharma. They had so much skill, they had so much talent. But I think they really didn't concentrate on it. Because the two players, I think, got chances very quickly at the age of 16, 17. Then they could not hold on to that adulation. Because sometimes when you're at that age, you know, you have to stay humble. You have to stay, on the ground. Because I think at that, those four players were very, very good, you know, as good as anybody when we used to play. I think I strongly believe that all the three formats can coexist, you know, because T20 is different, and now we have different teams for different formats. So I think I don't see there's any problem on that, you know, because it will coexist. Because with the IPL, with the advent of IPL, you have players, you have produced so many good players. Maybe especially if you take the case of Bumrah, maybe if you are not playing IPL, he would be playing now for India, not at 3 or 4 years back, because he showed the talent in IPL, because then it's totally easily recognizable. Then the moment he played IPL, then there are so many players who played just for India because of IPL. They got recognition very quickly, otherwise they would have recognized it, their talent very late, you know, because sometime in the olden days, before people used to say, are you going to play 3-4 Ranji Trophy, then we will play it later. By the time that he was over, that person, one season he didn't do well, then he said, yeah, it's over, let's go. It's not like that anymore now. Now it is totally different, you know, people who are there, you know, who have played well, they always come into the side, and then I want the players to, once they get their opportunity, you have to hang on to that opportunity. So once you get that opportunity, when you do well, I mean, you have to stay. I mean, you have to take that. And especially, I feel very sorry for Karan Nair. You know, he got a 100 in that game. You know, not, I think only two players have scored 100, Virendra Sehwag and him for India. I think no other player has scored 100. I feel sorry for him that after that, I mean, he could not do well and he could not play. I think he played 4 or 5 test matches after that and didn't even score a 50. But I think at that time, you know, people needed to guide him, because he needs guidance. Because when you score 300, you know, I mean, you're in a different zone, you know, like as they say nowadays, you know, we are in a happy place, you know, we're in good space. So, but I think it was too much good space. So we need to tell him, because I mean, as I've said, you know, I feel sorry, you know, but at the end of the day, you have to tell the players, you know, you have to guide them, because some players need a lot of guidance all the time. Some players don't need it, because, you know, some players are very professional. Some players, I mean, they take their talent for granted. So once they take their talent for granted, it becomes very, very difficult to go ahead with your career. Because there are so many players who have, I mean, like, I was wanting to tell you one thing also, because I mean, these people have played all very good till under-19 cricket. So when you play for India under-19, you really get recognized. So I remember when I played all the tournament before I played for all the games, big games for India before I played for India. The only category I didn't play was in under-19. I was not selected for under-19. I remember I went to Bangalore for my trials. I mean, I was leaving. My grandfather was a very pious man. So when I was leaving, he told me that your chance is still not here. I don't think you will get selected. Don't go. I said, Nana, I have to go. If I don't go, वैसे भी निकाल देते. So then I went there. They made me play only 3 balls, and then they said okay. So I had to come back. I went all the way to Bangalore to play 3 balls and come back. But I think that's how it is, you know, because sometimes you can't fight against destiny. Whatever is destined to happen, it will happen. There is no way, nobody can change that. That is true. You know, whatever the Almighty Allah wills, it will always prevail. Because we need to be patient, we need to really, especially the game of cricket has taught me a lot of patience. You know, be patient to hear people and talk to them and then give them good advice. Now, a lot of people come for, ask me for advice, you know, on batting and all. But the only thing I tell them, you know, as I've said, you know, I remember Pataudi sir words, I always tell them, as batting kar rahe, run banao. Don't complain, as wicket aisi nahi thi, wicket thara zu bhai, aisa ho gaya, aisa ho gaya. I understand, if you get a good ball, it's fine, everybody gets a good ball. But then, you can't complain all the time, ke wicket aisi, because you have to, as a batsman, you have to score runs. Because if you don't score runs, I mean, it becomes very difficult. Nowadays, you practice so much. Nowadays, the boys, you know, if I go, sometimes I go and see in the nets, I mean, they're practicing, somebody is throwing down, and all, like, 2-2 ghante practice karte. But I think it is, I mean, as far as I am concerned, it is not required to, I mean, bat for so long. Because if you're a good player, like, for example, if you're batting in nets, if you hit 20 balls in the middle, beyond that, what is that you want to do? I want to ask a question. If you hit 20 balls in the middle, that means you are playing well. I mean, you don't want to play with the edges after 20 balls. So once you play, once you know that you are hitting on the middle, And then I feel that, you know, you should not practice too much, you know, because then you know you're hitting, because then you'll save it for the match. But that is what is more important, because I know a lot of people are talking about India's loss, you know. I mean, we forget what we have, I mean, public memory is very, very small, but I think we need to learn to play swing bowling, you know, because playing swing bowling is a totally different technique. If you can't play like the way we play in under, I mean, in the T20s or 50 over game. When you play swing bowling, it's an art to bowl, to swing the ball. It's also an art to art for a batsman how to play swing bowling. So I think, I'm sure, you know, Indian team, I mean, it's a one-off thing, you know, they lost the series, but I think they will come back with a lot of learning, and I think I'm sure they will really do very well. But at the end of the day, I mean, the game is greater. I feel a game of cricket is greater than those who play it, because we must, you know, remember that people, a lot of people come and go, but the game is always going to stay. It's been there for almost like 150 years, maybe close to 150 years. It will be there for the people come and go, but the people who have impact, like Pataudi sir, I mean, why we are talking about him? Please tell me one thing. Because he's impacted the game. So that's why we are talking about him. That's why you have this M.A.K. Pataudi lecture. And it's done successfully. I think the Telegraph, I mean, ABP group has done it very successfully. And I didn't realize that, I didn't feel that, you know, I would talk so much. I mean, I was very, very, very... But I think Pataudi sir has made me do that. You know, like when I was playing, a lot of people had complained, and especially, I mean, the respected press people, kya zubaya baat hi nahi karte press conference mein, woh ekdam chote chote answers dete bolke bola. So I used to say, I mean, ab jo question puche usi ka answer dunga na. Because I always feel that, you know, because if you talk too much, then you start making mistakes. I mean, I always felt that way, you know, because if you see, even with political things, you know, when people, when they start saying, they do very good job, 10, 15 minutes, 20 minutes, but after that it becomes totally a different thing, you know, whatever you said good in the beginning, it's, nobody remembers that. So I feel that, I mean, you make a lot of mistakes when you talk, but I'm very happy that I was able to come here, and especially thank Indranil, you know, who has been very, very persuasive, and every time, every day he used to call 10 times, you know. Sometimes I couldn't receive his call because my dad was unwell for sometimes for a week or 10 days. So I couldn't take his call, but I think I must end now. I think I don't want to bore you people anymore. But I would like to thank the AVP, the Oberoi Group and the Bengal Club and Air India for having me here. You know, it's been an absolute pleasure, and a pleasure of mine to be here in Calcutta, which is my favorite city. As I've said, you know, it's been my savior forever. I also want to pray to the Almighty Allah that He grants Pataudi sir in the best, I mean, the highest form of heaven. That is my prayer for him. And I'm sure, you know, I mean, we have people here who everybody loves Pataudi sir, and then I'm sure everybody will have the same prayer. I sincerely hope and pray that he's very happy wherever he is, and I would like to thank everyone who's present here, especially ma'am. It's an absolute pleasure and honor for me to see you all the time, because you're looking, mashallah, say, alhamdulillah, very lovely, and I hope that Allah will grant you a very, very long and happy life, so that we learn a lot from you. By talking to you, by sitting next to you, I feel that I am learning something from you, ma'am. Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen, for having me here. Thanks a lot.
Thank you, sir. Thank you for the master flicks and straight drives. It was our pleasure to listen to you here today. Thank you, sir. Now it's my honor to welcome on stage the ever graceful and the ever elegant, our very own Mrs. Sharmila Tagore. Please, madam. Madam, we'll request you to say a few words, please.
I'm absolutely delighted to be here in Calcutta again, obviously my favorite city and also my favorite hotel, because ever since I remember I don't think there were very many hotels then, and have lovely fond memories of Oberoi. So that's again in a plus point, and with family and friends. And Azhar, your lecture today was so personal and so honest and so, like you say, straight from the heart, and you made many relevant points. And of course, I agree with you on, of course, in my Nikanama, it says that I must never, never remark on cricket. That's absolutely a no-no. But I think on another level, I'm saying that I agree, whether you're playing cricket or whether you're acting in films or succeeding in anything, that you must show your being happy in many ways, but not cursing and not using swear words, because all of us at that level are role models, and 15-year-olds, 12-year-olds are seeing you and trying to emulate you. So I also don't see any merit in being, and it might be considered very cool, but I think perhaps they can just be happy. Happy alone would tell the tale. And as you say that, we were playing at New Zealand, and in the AV that you saw earlier, we had made it for Tiger's 70th birthday. And 8 months later, we lost him. And somehow this AV was then made into a memorial kind of an AV, because a lot of people needed to show it for their... So this particular one, ABP has liked, and they always show it in every lecture. So it's been a very, very personal and a kind of a moving experience. And when you say that after so many similarities, the speaker before pointed out between you and Tiger, also you lost your son just a week before we lost Tiger. So that was again another very, very personal similarity. And it was really lovely. I just want to end with saying that in New Zealand now these boys are playing. I remember those days, for their Ranji Trophy, they used to get 10 rupees. And for Duleep Trophy, they were used to get 20 rupees. And then they had to pay for their laundry, because they used to wear white then. So it used to be quite a massive bill. And they couldn't fly. They had to go by train and many other things. And of course, girlfriends and wives were not allowed. So when they used to go to Australia to play, so it was Australia, 5 test matches, and then to New Zealand, another 5. And on the way back, they had to stop in Singapore. So that was many months. And I remember going to Chennai with Bapu Nadkarni's wife to see them off, because they were taking off from there for to Australia. Bapu wasn't keeping very well, so his wife was very unhappy. But anyway, so that was that, and then we came back. And then those days I didn't have a telephone. I don't know how many of you remember, but getting a telephone was a huge challenge. I mean, you had to beg, borrow, steal to get a phone. So I used to go to Raj, and of course mobile was never there. So I used to go to Raj Singh Ji's house in middle of the night at about 1 o'clock, and book a lightning call to Sydney. And of course, which wasn't lightning. It took an hour and a half, and would wait. And then every time the phone rang, I would quickly pick up the phone, and the other person on the phone on the other side would think that who's this woman in Raj Singh Ji, a bachelor's house, at 1 o'clock in the morning. So they would quickly put the phone down. And when the phone those days used to go via London to Sydney. So you can imagine, we could not hear each other. It was like our call drops these days, when you say, hello, hello, are you still there? Or can you hear me? So that's what used to happen, and often we would speak to each other via the operators. So we had to invite all of them to our wedding. So, I mean, nowadays they have such comfort, you know, wives, girlfriends, whatever they're allowed to be, and they can even walk into the dressing room, I believe. And Tiger would have none of that because, I mean, he wouldn't give us a ticket also. We all had to fend for ourselves and go and watch. Anyway, thank you so much for that wonderful, wonderful lecture. And as you said, Tiger made you speak a little bit more. You made me speak a little bit more. So thank you, and of course, thank you all of you, Air India, Oberoi, and all the other sponsors, Bengal Club and ABP, of course, which is again like family. Thank you very much.
Thank you, madam. Thank you. Now may I request Mr. Sanjay Mishra, Regional Director, Eastern Region, Air India, to come up on stage to hand over a token of appreciation to our guests. Mr. Mishra. Thank you, sir. Thank you, Mr. Mishra. Now may I request Mr. D.D. Purokayastho, MD and CEO ABP Group, to come on stage and felicitate the guests on behalf of the Telegraph. Sir, please. Sir, sir, I would request you to look at the screen, that what inside this. Look at the screen, sir. It's a sketch. That's the sketch. Thank you, sir. Thank you, Mr. Purokayastho. Now may I request Mr. Ambarish Dashgupta, main committee member and chairman, library subcommittee, the Bengal Club, to come up on stage and felicitate our guests. Ambarish, please. Now may I request Mr. Dashgupta to deliver the vote of thanks.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. The famous British journalist John Woodcock, once while describing or writing about Mr. Mohammed Azharuddin, mentioned that there is no use in asking the British cricketer or the English cricketer to bat like Mr. Azharuddin. It is like expecting a greyhound to win an Epsom Derby in the Surrey. So I remember also back in 1987, when I first got my job, I had to go to Hyderabad for the graduate induction training. And at that time, like all Indians, our cricketing soul was fully in love with Mr. Mohammed Azharuddin. And as I went to Hyderabad, I managed somehow to get hold of his residence number. And I dared to make a phone call, thinking, of course, or apprehending that the security will slam the call on me. But contrarily, a very affectionate lady voice picked up the phone and said, "Hello, who is this?" So I said tremulously that I'm such and such from Calcutta, an admirer of Mr. Azharuddin. I just wanted to say hello, and thinking that she will really be angry with me. But very affectionately, she said, "I am his mother, and I'm very sorry that he is now traveling. And next time you come back to Hyderabad, do ensure that you call him up and I will make him talk to you." So it was such a humbling experience, and that is the humble family, I think, from which Mr. Azharuddin hails. And that humbleness was very evident in his speech also, where he spoke all good things about all others, but hardly spoke about himself. We all knew that he is a man of lesser words, but we never knew that he is such a witty and humorous person till we heard him today. So we really appreciate his talk, which was laden with so much of wit and humor, interesting anecdotes, but still was bearing so much of meaning and significance and purpose. I also appreciate Madam Sharmila Tagore for her presence, without which this entire thing really seems very incomplete. Till she takes her chair, which is dedicated for her for the last 9 years, the whole thing seems very incomplete till that chair is being taken by her. I also appreciate Oberoi, ABP, Telegraph, 91.9, Bengal Club, of course, my club, for making this whole thing happen. And of course, at the end, we are indebted to the august presence of this audience for your kind presence. Thank you so much.